Good evening. Welcome to our show.
Are you ready for some oceans of fun?
It sounds a little fishy to me.
What?
Sounds a little fishy to me. That's the name of our program. Enjoy.
Whales are huge.
That much you know.
They make me shake from head to toe.
Most whales are harmless.
We know it's true.
They would never want to harm. They would never want to harm.
They are the biggest mammals in the deep blue sea.
I'd rather not have one swimming around me.
You have so many arms,
and when you reach and grab him,
you really mean no harm.
He loves to laugh and giggle, and squeal with such bliss.
He'll wrap his arms around you,
and give you a great big kiss.
Bye.
prima donna can be found in every single part of town. They sparkle and glow, oh so bright. A starfish is really quite a sight.
They'd steal the show if they could. Do they think this is Hollywood?
Ladies, hair and makeup, take one.
Should be against the law.
Everybody's scared of him, Marine's fishing men.
So if you see him coming near, swim as fastly as you can.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming to our show.
It has nothing to do with the ocean.
It's rather about you.
But we think it is special.
Of you.
We have some kids absent, so a song in honor of you is what was supposed to be.
Thank you.
7:20. The kids only have 3 more days left of school. They just woke up. Good morning, Tay. Taylor, good morning. Good morning, Bray Bray. 3 more days left of school. How do you feel about that? Good? Are you ornery?
No, I'm just very tired because I was sleeping in your bed last night, but I didn't have any covers because I was sleeping on the edge.
Well, I know. I woke up and saw you down there, and I put the comforter on you. Were you freezing? Well, why don't you go in your own bed then?
Because it was dark over there.
Well, you should have woke Mom or Daddy up. Honey, I'm sorry. Look at Taylor's wild hair. She just woke up. Show everyone your hair.
No.
Okay, smile. Let's see your teeth. No, okay, open up a little bit so we can see. Okay, just wait, let me get close. Okay, put your head straight. Okay, now open. See, she's got 2 permanent ones on the bottom and lost her top tooth. What a cutie. We gotta get you in the shower. Hurry, Mama's gotta get Cody to the vet. Let's get the animals on. Here's our new little one. Here's Shiley. Hi, Shy Shy. Good morning. There's Heidi. Hi, hi. You want to come in? Come on, Hi. Come on, Shy. Come in. Come in and eat. We've had Shiley for about 3 weeks now. New member of the family. Come on, Shy. Come in. Come on. Come in and eat. Good morning. Good morning, Shy. Yeah. All right. Here's Shiley. She's snoring a little bit. There's Heidi. Hi, Heidi. Hi, baby. Are you camera shy? Okay, here we are getting ready to go. There's Shiley drinking some water. Yay. Here's Grandma.
Oh,
getting
so
organized.
Hot.
Nikki and Jenna saying bye. Get their intimate moment.
Does any of this need to go?
Yeah, that's all done. I'll come back and get it. Let me just.
What's this?
What? No, I'm with CDs for up front, maybe. Getting all set to go. Here's my lovely husband. Bray, say hi.
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 We're just saying hi to
Lukey.
We're just saying hi to Lucas.
Can you say
hi,
doot doot?
Luke.
Doot doot. Doot.
He got 2 boogers in his mouth.
Oh, great. Let's see if you...
That one is the big one in his nose.
Brayden says into the camera, Lucas has 2 boogers in his nose.
Quack, quack.
We're just getting
ready.
Okay,
I'm going to be signing off. We're getting ready to head out of Dodge.
Yeah.
On our way to Chicago and Indiana. What?
We're just getting ready to go on a trip right now.
I know.
We're going to lots of states, and we're going to go for 17 days.
Yeah, maybe 17 days. If everything goes good, we'll be gone for 17 days.
And I'm 6
maybe
years.
16. We'll see.
Or maybe we'll be back tomorrow.
Yeah, who knows? Let's hope not.
Take a picture of Shy.
I want to be gone at least 2 days with all the 2 nights with all the
Mom,
packing I've done.
Mom,
you get her some
look
water?
Look at Shai.
Yeah, she had some.
Look at Shai.
She drank any of it? Yeah. When I wasn't looking, she will.
Hi, Shai.
Hey, beautiful Nikki. Why? First night in Illinois. There's the camper. There's Shiley. Wonder where I am, I'm sure.
Oh, damn it, they're gonna get scratched.
Here's Grandma. Don't do that, that's how you scratch them. Did you bring a towel?
Yeah, but I don't like that one. That's short.
All right. Are you going to get back in or are you going to get out? Yeah, your ball's going away.
Just lay down and cover up with it. Great. Here, just lay down. I'll cover you up.
There. Hey, Bray, say something.
What?
Did you have fun riding in the back of the camper? Port Charles, Ohio. I think that's Jenna. Yeah. Taylor. Ray.
Hi.
Here's the little girl that we met, Monica. Brayden and Grandma. Stop it.
No, that's my towel. Oh.
Stay over here. No. We're in the camper. Got done swimming. Got out of the shower. Here's Jenna.
Wonder how far that is.
It's the 4th of July today. We're in Port Clinton, Ohio.
What is that called? Sandusky.
Who is Mom talking to?
Herself.
Mom, can you see my flag?
Yes, I can. It was in my way. I should have videotaped you two this morning when you're all decked out. Hair done, makeup on. Grandma's talking to herself. That's a sign of old age. She's upstairs talking to herself.
Mama.
Can you see my head? Can
you
see me? Kim, I said you could come up.
Oh, she's talking to Grandpa.
And I said, Jenna, you need to open your towel. And are you going to get your hair done now, or did you do it?
No, I need you to do something.
We're at a park here. A memorial vet park. Come on, Shy, keep going. I'm coming.
Come on, follow her. Look at that.
Grandpa, will you walk?
I can do it.
Whatever.
Let's go over and look at this howitzer.
China! China!
Today is the 4th of July, Independence Day. Woo! When was Independence? 1775 or something? I don't know.
1776.
Six?
What's she doing? She kind of.
Yeah, see,
mocked.
That's her walking. Oh, she's peeing.
Oh, were you peeing? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't pull your peer out.
18.
Oh, now look at her. See, isn't she fun to walk?
Smell like gas.
I smell gas, yeah.
Natural gas.
I know. Here, I'll.
Airport.
Hmm.
No, but Mama, videotape me walking around the circle.
All right, here we go.
Come on.
She didn't poop or something, did she? That I smell. Make sure you're being respectful. You can dance, but be quiet. You're scaring her. You're scaring her, don't. Listen. Port Clinton. There's Taylor going down the slide. Hey Tay, wave at the camera. Woo! And there's my brave boy. Be careful. Start. And here's where we're
going to
be sitting. There's Jenna, Grandpa, and Grandma.
Okay, Mom, videotape me on the side.
Okay, just wait. And the fireworks are going to be shot off.
Today's the 4th of July.
Yeah.
And I'm 6 years old. And I have a nice hairdo.
I'm not it no more.
Who is?
I want to be ready.
fireworks, who's gonna go off?
That's how it gets dark. Kylie's back at the campsite in the camper. Hopefully doing fine. Here we are, watching the fireworks.
Doesn't anybody want to cheer?
No.
I think you got it. It's probably gonna go over or be over.
Yeah. I don't even know if Jenna will show up. There's Jenna. There's Brayden.
No, I gotta hold your hand. Hold your hand or I hold your
hand. We're not really showing up. It's too dark.
I wanna see if it's showing up.
See how dark it is?
Yeah. Better view with your head. In the draw.
I wanna see. Mama, can
better
you
view what, Dad?
You're
oh, and then
lacrosse.
I know.
Mom, can you go get me a chair?
No. Sit on Grandpa's lap. The mosquitoes are kind of bad, so Grandma's sitting in the chalk right behind us. Oh, that was pretty. Yeah.
Look, Mom.
All right, here's Jenna. It's
hey,
after the fireworks. Now we're doing some sparklers.
Where are they? Oh, here.
Whoa.
Here's Taylor. She's afraid to do them right now, but she'll do them. Grandpa getting them going.
There
here's Bray.
For me.
He's excited. Not for you, did you say? Bray,
yeah.
What did you say?
For me. This one's for me.
Okay, I figured. You'd like to play with fire.
Yep.
A little fire bug. Uh-oh.
Here, Taylor.
What, we got
a
dud?
Taylor, this one's a long one. Look at this long one.
Just save that one for me.
You gotta do some.
Sure.
Woo! Great, grab the end. You're fine.
Grab it right there. You're fine.
I used to do these when I was young, too.
Okay.
Can I do two at a time?
Give me another one.
Don't touch it, Bray. Just do it exactly what you're doing, okay? Stay away from Jenna, though.
Okay. Tay, you want one?
Yeah, Tay, you take one. Okay?
It's nothing to be scared of, honey.
No, it's not.
No. Well, it is a little bit to be scared of, but hurry. Who's going to
do it? Yeah, but that's sparking. I can't get it.
Oh, you can't do it? Just grab it on the bottom there. Look out.
Watch out. Watch out, just go.
Hey, don't get it caught in your jimma booga.
The wabba jinga.
Booga.
I'd like y'all to have one at the same time. That'd be
okay,
great. And get a picture
right
of you guys.
By my feet.
Okay.
Them up.
No.
Yes, okay.
You don't have to do them, Taylor, but you know.
Hey, this is the whole reason we waited for them.
Light yours from Jenna's, maybe. So it's in your hand already.
What
you should do, maybe, is just light it while it's in Taylor's hand. I don't know if that would help.
Here we go.
Okay.
How'd you do that? What happened?
Yeah.
We're going to have to pick them up when we're done.
Yeah,
try
set
to find them.
Over by my
set them over. Oh, my gosh. Oh, gosh. Who gave her something to drink?
Woo! Well, you drank so much sugar and caffeine.
No,
I can't get into this thing.
There's Grandma sitting in the car.
She's like, what the heck?
She's bug-proof.
Yeah.
I can't get this thing over. We're
gonna
have to blast.
And it's over. Okay.
Get the fire department over here. Okay. Oh, there's a lot of them here. Okay.
Can't find it.
Set them by my feet so we clean
up. Okay, light Shannon. Where are you? Where are you?
Well, there's one over here, I thought.
Yeah, I know.
Got a big box.
Here, let's see.
Here. I'll get him. What are you doing?
Look at the fairy.
That fairy. Oh, yeah.
Cool.
This is Lake Erie right behind us.
Do you have them open, Grandpa?
Yep.
Oh, okay.
All right.
You want
that's
me to
take
that. I'll light them.
There's
the
fairy.
No, that's just here, Grandpa. Let us pull on for them.
Ooh, I like that smell.
That's it.
Okay.
Not of the sewer, but.
Grab it. Right on the bottom.
Yeah. Who wants it?
Oh.
Grandpa, let me hold on to it.
I'm burning myself.
No, Grandpa.
Okay.
Uh-oh, battery's going. A little nervous. That's okay, though. Just try it, T. I promise you'll like it. Livy was even doing them.
Yeah, Livy's not scared. Come on. There we go.
Teal, you can handle it. Except for if you're nervous, maybe you shouldn't, because then you'll, like, throw it or something.
Okay,
set it by my feet.
Taylor, do you think you'll do it or not? I wanted to videotape you doing one.
Taylor, come on, hold on.
Here, just hold yours to hers and it'll light.
Yeah, just hold it. Come here, hurry.
Oh. You can
end,
do it.
Taylor.
It's gonna
come
end.
On,
just
hurry.
Hold it to it.
Hurry.
This.
Come on, Taylor.
Okay.
Come.
Okay. Bye bye. Okay, over and out. Everyone, say bye. Say happy 4th of July.
Happy 4th of July. Me doing it.
I can't. My battery's going, honey.
Hurry. Take that one, Taylor.
Grab it.
Let Taylor take it.
Let
Taylor take it.
Just on the end there.
Yeah, there. Take it, Tay. Hurry up.
Yay!
See, you're doing just fine. Move away from Grandpa more.
Yeah, I don't like the outside.
He's got on Grandpa already.
He needs to keep all the hair he's got on his head.
Taylor,
Dennis.
Taylor.
Yeah, I don't have much.
Away from Grandpa.
Oh,
good job, Tay.
Try and light the other one.
Happy 4th. I'm going to have to sign out now.
There you go.
Bye-bye.
Happy 4th of July. Oh, what are you doing?
Okay.
Here we are, Gettysburg Battlefield. Just starting our tour. This is the light of the eternal flame. There's Jenna. There's Grandma. Here's some of the battlefield we just drove through. This barn was standing during the battle. Our truck. Eternal flame, peace, eternal, and nation, united.
You can go ahead.
No problem.
I just didn't want to be known as, who's that guy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bray, please don't throw anything.
Mom, can we still find bullets up here and stuff?
Yeah, but you can't keep them.
Can you do what?
Still find bullets up here.
Oh, I don't think so.
You can find bullets, probably, but you can't keep them.
You guys can walk. That's fine. There's the railroad tracks.
What? Mom, look at that rock!
It looks like some of Shiloh's
cemetery from the poorhouse during Gettysburg time. We just wanted to see if there were some names and dates on here. And there are. Mary Bollinger, July 2nd, 1913, aged 92 years. Died 1913. Any younger than the 1900s?
Yeah, over here is the
1800s.
They died in 1898, it looks like. Really hard to read. 1892, maybe right there.
Aged 36 years, I believe it says. They're really weathered.
This one says Allie Feeling.
I think 39 years on that one too.
1879, that one says. Was where the poorhouse was standing, right in this area during Gettysburg time. Obviously, the poorhouse has been torn down and now it's a cemetery. We're up in a big watchtower. Okay, stay right with those guys. I'll be up here a few minutes.
Federal infantry was down below those trees down in the woods, and they were getting hit with some of the short shots. You know? The commander of the Confederate artillery was only 17 years old.
Really?
Yeah.
Downtown Gettysburg. We're gonna find a place to eat and get some souvenirs. Brayden wants to get a gun or a sword.
But
some
I
kind
didn't
of weapon.
Get one in that shop. And I really wanted it really bad, but Mom said no.
Okay, Bray. Know what they said? It was pricey.
You guys.
Let's just peek at this next area. Gibson's.
How about you guys go on your own? I'm gonna go get fuel, and I'll call you on the phone.
You're not hungry?
I'm hungry, but I can't be hitting every little cafe in town trying to figure out if I'm gonna.
It's almost 2:30. We'll never get done with our other thing either.
Well, where do you want to go then? Well, I don't want to screw around.
Hello. You mock my husband.
Where's it? This is the memorial of Pennsylvania that they erected. Windy. are still at the Pennsylvania. Very pretty monument. And here, kind of like the Vietnam Memorial, it lists all of the names of the soldiers that died. Corporals, captains, sergeants. This is just surgeons, the 35th Infantry, 6th Reserve, 38th, 39th, 40th, 41st, and so on. Name after name of all the soldiers killed. It's a beautiful day out. Minnesota Memorial.
Wave again. How's the view?
I believe there
was 80. Reynolds, Mead, Pennsylvania. Union. They knew what I said before. This lists everybody that fought. And here it says the star indicates if they're killed or mortally wounded. So when you look at it that as a whole, there's not a whole lot per line so far. Or is Henry Gibson.
This can't be all Pennsylvania.
This is Henry Gibson. He died.
There's Lincoln.
So that's how you look at this. This lists all the general officers. I know that's a lot of Pennsylvania. How can that be?
Well, look over here. Did you read this in Pennsylvania and Gettysburg?
No. Pennsylvania at Gettysburg. 69 regiments, infantry, 9 regiments, cavalry, 7 batteries, artillery. Total present, 34,530.
Wow. More steps.
34,000.
Okay.
Killed and mortally wounded, 1,182. Wounded, 3,177. Missing, 860.
That might be him, too. What are you talking about? Simon Summer.
Still touring Gettysburg. Did you look at Devil's Den?
Yeah, I mean, I went over there.
Is anything special?
Well, they show the picture of a body in there. There's a monument. One of the famous pictures right here.
Virginia Monument. Virginia to her sons at Gettysburg. And here is the battle. Where the Confederates went out to meet the Union, which were across that way. 12,000 soldiers, Confederate soldiers, 1 mile long, went to meet the Union soldiers. And right down this pathway is where General Lee apologized to the soldiers
for getting employed. Here we are. We're watching The Master of Disguise. Thursday evening.
Who's your daddy?
Who's
your daddy? Oh, I like
okay,
this part.
So
Mom, videotape this.
That's my
water.
I'll just videotape you guys.
Mom.
That was a man.
That was a man.
It's a man.
He's a lady.
We're watching Master of the Skies. So it's
of
really
the disguise.
Funny. But Mom, the funniest part on here is
no, don't tell
when Master of the Skies turns into the turtle.
No, that's not.
Oh, I saw that in the back of the box.
I said you guys
Friday morning. I think it's Friday. Taylor, wake up. I'm videotaping you. Did something fall on your head, Bray?
Sorry.
You okay, baby? It is 7:30 here, 6:30 our time, 7:30 here.
Okay.
Try to get out of bed. Hey, shy, Shyly. Hi. Hi, Shy. Taylor, wake up. Hey, Bray, look at Mom. Good morning. We're going to go up to the house and take a shower. Okay. I have no clue. All right, everyone, let's get up.
Mama, my undies are
your undies are wet? Here we are in Williamsburg, Virginia. There's Bray Bray.
Mom, I feel a lot better. So I pulled the skin off.
Be quiet. We don't want to hear that. People won't want you swimming if you have a yucky toe, okay? All right?
Okay.
Okay. Let's go swim. So I can videotape you swimming.
It still hurts.
Okay, I want to videotape you swimming.
Okay, watch me jump in.
Walk, though. Good job. Okay, show me how you swim.
Get the water slime, won't you jump in?
Okay, show me how you do it. You swim.
Oh. I may do paddle dogs.
Well, I want to see you dog paddle then. You can do the front crawl.
I may dive.
No, you can't dive. It's not deep enough. You can't do that. Okay, go ahead. Start swimming. Good job. Yeah. I will in a minute. I want to get Jenna. Jenna, say hi!
Emma, watch me.
Yeah.
Mom, watch me. Watch me jump in.
This way.
I'm gonna do a flip. Mom, watch me jump in. I'm gonna do a flip. Okay?
Nope, you can't do a flip. Just wait, please.
Okay, Mom, just watch.
Just wait, I'm videotaping the girls. Now you're in the way, big head.
Okay, watch.
Okay. I'm watching. Shyly. There she is. Bray, don't scream. Here they are. Rollerblading at Williamsburg Campground, Williamsburg, Virginia. Look at Jenna go.
Don't I vibrate?
Yeah.
Mom, over there in that camper next door.
Okay, if you guys want to go the opposite way now and do what you want, that's fine. I want to get you on camera. Good job, Taylor. How do your rollerblades work? Pretty good?
Good, they hurt my heels.
Okay, next year we'll get you some nice ones. These won't fit you next year, I'm sure.
Mom.
What?
I only do good when I'm rollerblading on driveways. I don't do good on roads.
Yeah, this is bumpy.
Like
it's bumpy.
Rack roads.
Whoa, look at Jenna go. Don't skin up anything. You'll be hurting and crying.
I am hurting.
Well,
I'm proud of my skating.
Yeah, you're getting really good. So is Bray. Think of how easy roller skating will be at the roller rink then. Jenna even turns. You gotta teach Taylor that.
Boom!
Hey. How are those hamburgers we had tonight? Those turkey burgers. Pretty good, huh?
Good.
Good.
Are you mocking me?
Dad's setting up the satellite dish.
Oh, okay, I see it.
There's the pool. The lifeguard was sleeping over there for a while.
Oh, Mom, can I videotape my gun? Can I have my gun in my hand?
Not with rollerblades on. No, not with rollerblades on, Bray. That'll be too hard. You'll fall.
You'll fall and break your gun.
My gun in my hand.
Or your neck.
Yeah, when you get shoes on later, we will.
Neil Williamsburg, they're having a farmer's market.
We should.
That's a lot of dogs around here.
Still got it going on. Mom, I wish we got a donation.
Oh, yeah.
This was
a long time ago.
Jenna, Taylor, look at me.
My kids.
Jenna.
That's his mama.
I just want you to look at.
Oh, my, look at the big poodle behind you.
I know.
Over here.
This one.
There's a lot of dogs.
What?
Did you see the
picture of the basket?
Here, Tay, let me see you.
What's it?
Ray, look, let me see you.
Steam crabs.
Oh, it's just music. No one's playing.
She's singing. Yeah, she's singing.
Where?
Singing,
oh, I don't playing. See anyone. Oh, I saw the speakers. Well, who is it?
You know how you make homemade salsa and stuff? In the olden days, people did that with tomatoes and like pickles. How your grandma Charlotte makes pickles now. Grandma Phillips did it. I did it for a while, but I didn't really want. And then they would do all that from the green beans from the garden and like carrots from the garden, some kind of potatoes that would can. And they have all in the different milk bottles. So they opened that up. I had a bad dream about it one day. I still remember it.
Why did you have a bad dream?
Because we just opened
the door. Over there.
We used to open the door.
What?
The man.
And go down in there.
In the outfit.
And get Grandma Phillips canning. Like, yeah, there's pickles and tomatoes and all this stuff. And we just put it in the garden.
Howdy.
Yesterday when I got my hat.
Yeah.
I want to go to a shop there like right now, like today.
Why? What would you get there?
Garden like they used
I don't
to
know.
Have.
You don't need anything.
Look
more.
At all the bees. They're pollinating in there. See?
What bees?
They take over here on this branch. See, they go in there and they take the nectar from those and they go to another plant and
yeah,
that's
I
called
know.
Pollinating. You know how to do that?
It's
and then that's what makes the other plants grow. What a beautiful garden. These are cucumbers here. Hey.
This way.
Can we go in?
Judge Tucker. Best.
looked here yet.
And what's not said is that there are persons buried within the floor of the church at 42.
42?
In, wow. In the house of the church.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Wow.
I know.
So, and what years were those taking place in?
It took place in 1700.
I just walk out there now.
The church was built in 1715. Mm-hmm. And it's just a time to be buried.
I didn't know what.
And when the restoration is taking place, this is when it's discovered.
But then again,
we
found the list of it about
700 years.
What's that?
Who was the first? The Washington's grandfather was the first minister here.
Wow. Isn't that neat, guys?
17 mm-hmm. people buried in the aisles of the church.
I thought they said 40.
Oh, did she say 40?
40 some people are buried here in the aisles of the church.
1700.
No, I knew it was 17. Maybe that's what just heard the tale. I wasn't up there. But she said the people didn't actually probably sit in these pews.
Oh, John Marshall. John Marshall, right here.
Who was John Marshall? Yeah.
Usually, she said, in order of prominence is how they sat in the church. So the governor sat over there.
John Tyler.
All his,
Thomas Jefferson. General George Washington. Wow. Who's this?
James Monroe. James Monroe. Monroe.
Braden, please help. That's where the pastor would be up there. You can go ahead. No big deal. Anything over here?
Could include all that. And do you know what that pass runs for?
I think it's 39 or 34.
Oh, okay.
Come on, Bray.
But if you get the pass right there, then you can start visiting all these places.
Mm-hmm.
You've got about a mile.
Mm-hmm. Come on, Brayden.
Yes, this is the entrance for the Whip property. They'll be out in a few minutes to fetch the next one.
Thank you.
They got the 18th century dispensers.
You can get a can of pop anytime you wanted to.
Look, they just painted it and the bird just pooped over there. Looks nice and painted until that bird poops. This is the governor's mansion or palace or whatever it is. Governor's house. And Thomas Jefferson and John Henry, I think, both used to live here. They were governors. Mom, was it John Henry?
John Henry.
Okay.
No, Patrick Henry.
Patrick Henry. Patrick Henry and Thomas Jefferson both lived in the governor's palace here that I was just showing you. Pretty cool. Watch out for the fence, Bray. It's very old and brittle.
I call my house the governor's house.
Woolly they are too, so maybe they'll give them a haircut and get all their wool off.
We'll find you a house, okay?
I think the trees look like they need a bath, don't they?
Why won't they paw back?
They're busy eating. Well, they don't have to mow the lawn.
Maybe they don't come over where the grass is gone.
Oh, what's on these trees? What kind of trees are these, Mom? With these red things, what are on these trees?
Cherries.
What, your foot hurts?
He's got a bad foot.
So based on Felicity's house, in the book, it was described by this house.
The Powell House.
This is the Powell House. So we found it in Colonial Williamsburg.
Does it look like a
hero?
Well, it's got to be, because she said that.
Well, the book might have been based on it, but the movie might have been different.
Well, yeah.
They said that they came here.
The movie was in Canada.
No, but they said
but
they
still,
came
they can
here,
recreate the
they
house.
They filmed the outsides of the movie.
Oh, well, yeah.
For the outsides of the houses for the movie, but then they did like that. They built that.
Hello.
Sound stage on there that looked like this.
Yes? Mm-hmm. Oh, in front of Tarpley and Company store. We just went inside to look at gifts and souvenirs. This is one of the stores that Felicity went in. Felicity that played Felicity on the American Girl Felicity movie went in here and shopped around. And there's another store down the street that we're going to be going to. So we're going to go check it out. And right now they have some revolutionary act going on down here. Raiden, please tell hon.
Whatchamacallit? What, the lanterns and stuff? Had two lanterns out?
Oh.
oldest college in the United States, aside from Harvard. College of William and Mary. A charter was granted by King William and Queen Mary in 1693. So if you can believe that. So here they are waiting for me. I must hurry. They're all waiting. We're just leaving Williamsburg. Time to go to Jamestown, I guess. So that's what we're doing. We're already tired from all the walking. Yorktown. Sunday morning.
This area, especially Williamsburg, you see musicians wearing red coats, that's because of the area. They would be wearing the reverse of whatever their regular finish would be.
Yes.
So
can you go walk around?
I'm not sure. Okay. They're saying, are you fast? And he's going, no.
This is my crew. Who thinks they look confused? Who thinks they look like they know what they're doing? Ladies and gentlemen, what they need is a gun captain.
When it's time, will you take a picture of them? If you get a good shot.
Trigonometry.
Take a picture of
them. And a good captain should know a little bit about natural philosophy as well. You gotta have a big voice. You gotta know what you're doing. You gotta command some respect. And when you tell these people to get it done, they gotta do it. I'm looking for somebody with lots of authority. I'm looking for a mom or a military man.
Swing over.
All right, one more right here.
Gun attention!
Right here.
Gun attention!
Who wins?
Hell!
Hustle up, let's go! Come on, let's go, hustle up.
Hey, Brayden.
Hustle up, let's go! All right, guys, let's get their attention. What's a good military term used to get people's attention? All right, guys, let's, get it attention! Very good. Billy's in chest out, hands down by your side, look forward! All right, gun cap, take a look at your men. Make sure they got everything they need to fire the gun. Go ahead, take a look.
How they look, sir?
You doing good?
Excellent. You keep an eye on him, make sure he does this right, okay? You're being great.
Good. Come back with the sergeant.
All right, let's get them in position. They're not doing a spot of good right here. Next command.
Man the peace!
They'll do a sharp right about face. And step up to the gun. Look at him go. All right.
About 20 seconds.
How are we doing so far? I don't think we're out of time, aren't we? All right, guys. This is a fairly large field gun. They're standing outside the wheels. They're not close enough to move. Let's give them one more command to get them in position.
From right to left, dress!
All right, let's ask them to slip into the gun. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I showed you a 6-pound ball. What I have here is a 6-round cartridge. There's my 6-pound ball right there. There's that wood disc ball that said, oh, like you saw in the case shot. Corporal, show them where the manhole is. Guys, when I fire out gun, this stuff doesn't all come out. And after 4 or 5 shots, this stuff starts building up in the breech. Maybe I can't properly see the cartridge or work. That's not a good thing, is it? We need to get that out. After about every 5 shots, we will start with this command.
Search piece!
Gunner's front left has the wad hook or a worm. Take a torch through the device, 6 into the barrel. Run it back to the breech, turns it clockwise 2 or 3 times. Well, that was pretty good, wasn't it?
Yeah.
She got that before I got done talking. Give her a round of applause. All right. Now, after every shot, small pieces of stuff were made inside the tube. Manhole at the back of the gun. If we sponge the piece now, all that stuff inside that tube is coming up through the manhole on top of my 2 people in red. Not a very good idea. Hold up your left hand there. Everybody see that? That is a thumb stall, a piece of leather that will allow her to seal off the vent hole without burning her thumb with the next command.
Can vent!
All right, seal off the vent. Now we can safely
sponge piece!
All right, now we sponge the piece from the muzzle to the brake. Go ahead, sponge it, let's go. There's a trick to this, guys. If you're not tending properly, you got a good chance this gun may be going off and you don't want it to. It's a very important step to do. Alright. These are side boxes. When the gun is going from place to place, the side boxes are on the carriage, they're full of these. When I'm shooting the gun, firing the weapon, I don't want these boxes full of these up there, do I?
No.
So they're removed, but it's time to get one of these cartridges from the side box to the loader with the next command.
Handle cartridge!
Alright, we open up the side box, pull out a cartridge. Stick it in the side pouch. Run it up to the front of the gun. Hand it off to the loader. Runs back to the side box.
There you go.
Very good.
Yay.
For the first time. Loader has the cartridge. Cartridge needs to get in the gun. Next command.
Charge piece.
All right, stick the cartridge in the muzzle. The muzzle's the fire into the gun. Where does the cartridge need to go? Back to the breech. How do we get it there?
Ram down cartridge.
All right, the other end of the sponge is called the ram. Stick it in the barrel, ram the cartridge all the way back to the breech. All right, pulls it back out, sets it back in position. It's time to make the fuse. Next command.
Prime!
Good at the right rear, pulls out a pick out of the shoulder strap and sticks it down through the vent hole and actually pokes a hole in this cartridge bag right here, exposing powder inside the tube. Slap the side pouch, opens it up, pulls out a paper tube full of loose powder, bites off the end and spits it out. Bite and spit. All right, throw it. There you go. Takes the loose powder, pours it down in the vent hole at the top of the gun. There's a flat spot called a vent field. Gunpowder lays on top of that, goes down through the vent hole, makes contact with gunpowder. Right there, I have a fuse. So here we are. We've cleared the gun. We've loaded the gun. We have a fuse. Silence from the gun captain. What shall we do now?
Aim it.
Is anybody here?
Fire!
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 Amen!
Amen!
crowd because you're all right. Most people want to do what right now?
Fire.
Fire the thing, right? Who would be unhappy right now if I fired a gun? Yeah. It's called recoil, guys. When you fire this gun, it rolls backwards. It weighs 1,200 pounds. Those guys do not. They can't win that fight. We need to get them out of the way. And before I fire any gun, put it on the enemy. We're going to do two things with the next command.
Take aim!
All right, Commander, take aim. Gun pass. Come over here. We're going to aim the gun. Happy? Is everybody safe? Can we fire the gun?
No.
No. You guys did so good on my last question. What's the matter? There's some people up there at the front of the gun?
Yes.
Yes, there are. Yes, there are. Ladies at the front of the gun.
Sir.
Are you behind the ball until the end of ball comes out?
Yes, sir.
Which way does the ball go?
Forward.
Which way does carriage roll? Backward?
Backward.
There you go. Are you perfectly safe where you're at?
Yes, sir.
All right, you trust what I do. Guys, this gun is big enough they can stand there, but they're behind the muzzle. Everything moves in the opposite direction from where they stand. They're perfectly safe. Who thinks my gun captain's going to hit the target the first time?
I do.
Is that your wife over there?
No, mother-in-law.
Mother-in-law.
I know he's right.
Guys, it doesn't matter how good you are. You're probably not going to hit your target the first time. You do something called a ranging shot. You're putting the gun up there fast. You're doing some quick moves like this to line the gun up fairly close. You fire it. See where it goes. Put the gun right back where it was, make some minor adjustments, and get yourself on target. Now, when the gun rolled away, who makes good markers? Put the gun right back where it was. Those two at the front of the gun. See how that works?
Oh,
all right, guys. No? Ooh! Wasn't that exciting?
20 seconds.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we like to have a lot of fun when we do this. That's quite a process, is it not? Seriously, we're trying to do that in around 20 seconds, and seriously, this is serious business. If you miss one of those steps, bad things can happen. The gun maybe doesn't go off, or goes off when you don't want it to, while the men are around the gun working on it. Those are all bad. Very serious business. About 20 seconds or so to get it done. So would you like to have this team right here as your gun crew or what?
Yeah.
Oh, they're okay. For the first time out, let's give these guys
great.
A round of applause. Just a moment or so to get it ready. Guys, remember, this is a field gun, but you're at Yorktown. Yorktown is a place that the British have dug in. They built a bunch of earthworks. They're standing behind that. They're going to make this a base of operations in New Virginia, so they're entrenched. To get them out, we got to pound them out with our own artillery. So we're going to dig our own trenches. Guys, I'm trying to knock down earthworks that are as much as 20 feet thick in spots. When I fire a 6-pound ball at 1,200 feet per second at a 20-foot earthworks, will it do some damage? Certainly will, but how about if I had an 18 or 24-pound ball traveling 1,200 feet per second? Would that be better?
Yeah.
But those guns are too heavy to bring over land. So what happens on September 5th, the French fleet will take control of Chesapeake.
Move to your left a little bit.
Right to left, dress! Third feet!
It's all right, you cover your ears.
Cover your ears.
Quick, move!
Okay.
All right, guys. Awesome. projectile. That's why the gun didn't recoil too much. You put 2 pounds of powder in there with a projectile, guess what? That thing would probably roll right off the platform, but I think you get the idea, do you not?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, that pretty much concludes our demonstration. If you have questions, feel free to come on down and see me. If you want to have a closer look at the gun, feel free to do that. Make sure you see the farm site and the campsite on your way out. And guys, we appreciate you coming out, and you have a good day.
Look in the. Oh, I see you. There's Bray getting his clothes on. There's Jenna. Let's see you, Jen. Wait, let me get a close up. Cute. Let's see, Tay. Let me get a picture of you like that, Tay. Why are you putting them back on?
Bridge. Sorry, Mom. Look at, see, this is, there's Virginia Beach.
Oh my God.
Oh, I'm getting Mom's face.
Over here is.
Can you watch the
Virginia
road?
Virginia Oliver.
Okay, there's
Hi, Mom,
a ship out there somewhere.
The
Alright, I'm just showing you real quick and then I'll over and out it. You see, kids, we're just driving over the ocean now. Look at, see these things? There's nothing on either side of it. It's just this
What's
bridge
that?
Goes right down straight in the ocean.
Holes on my
see it?
You got the wettest
Is
holes
it deep
still.
Right here?
Look at them out here fishing.
Tim,
fishing.
Yeah, there's sharks down there.
Watch the road.
There's sharks down there, guys.
I'm nervous.
Sharks and whales and
there's
dolphins.
A big ship right there. And right out there too.
Well,
oh, I want
whale's
that one.
Tail.
You can
How
see it sometimes.
How would we see a whale's tail?
Or a whale.
You never know.
Yeah, you guys will like Washapeg, I think. I mean, it's just quiet. Like, we can walk around there.
Oh, you got it. This joker comes out.
No swearing that video. Just kidding.
Should prefer it, actually.
How did we ever stop up there?
Just pulled up there and stopped.
I know, but then we have to turn the whole rig around.
I don't know, but we did.
Look at Thimble.
You let us shop.
Shoal Channel Tunnel.
Are you sure no gifts?
Yes, I'm sure.
Just let him watch the road. Don't interview
him. Yeah. Let me try to keep this thing.
Okay, slow down.
Okay, now watch
slow
for
down.
Water.
Oh, look at how
okay, we're in the
look
tunnel.
At the steep hill we're going down. It's getting
we're
chilly.
Going underneath the
yeah,
ocean.
It's cold in the ocean.
Yeah.
It is cold in the ocean.
You can feel like, how much colder it got here.
Watch for mermaids.
Hi, Jenna.
Hi. Sorry.
Stop it.
Hey, Sean. Oh, her big nose getting on the camera. Oh, whiskers, heads, hairy legs. Alright, I'm gonna over and out it.
Thank goodness.
Oh, do you have something to add?
Yeah.
Pan around.
I'm very nervous.
Okay, we're still on the bridge.
Can you see up here, kids, where the bridge
you
ends?
You can see where it ends. And we go into the tunnel. And then we get back on the bridge.
Can you see where it ends?
We're already on the second part. We're already out of the tunnel. Mm-hmm. More on the bridge now, and then we go back down.
So actually, that's still the bridge where the rocks are?
That's where the tunnel is, underneath. We go back in the tunnel underneath.
Oh, people are going to get sick when they watch this.
See, look at that semi going over there.
Now,
pretty soon he's going
to
go straight down into the tunnel.
Around the bridge. Look at all of them.
See, there he's going to go downhill into the tunnel.
People fishing out ahead.
We are in, I think it's called Port Charles. Right on. The Atlantic Ocean.
Mm-hmm.
Don't do that.
Sorry.
Don't splash me.
Jim, I want to go up there. I want to take them. Around down there. Let's go.
But you just said there's no place to really swim by his place, then?
No,
there isn't? That's sad. Wait, I don't know. Oh, that's sad.
Well, I don't know what. You know.
Why can't we swim there?
I'm the swimming pool.
It's all like marshy.
Maybe. We'll see what happens. Well, he can. He can take us out to the boat.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we'll talk. See where he can take us out swimming someplace. It might be similar to this. All right. I had to go up kind of check on things. It is, 4:30.
We'll meet you back there at 7?
5 o'clock, gang. We're taking off. The bus is leaving. The bus leaves at 5 o'clock.
It's 4:26
right now. Okay. Look at this kid. And Taylor starts screaming, a jellyfish.
Oh, mother finds.
And look at what we found. Yeah, let's go see what Grandma found. No, like, just wait, guys. Let's get it on tape.
Look at the jellyfish that I found.
It's really jelly-like. I don't know what it is. Where'd it go now?
I can't believe I found it.
Taylor, we can
video
on it. Say hello.
Hello.
Turn around, let's get your beautiful hair on tape. Hey, slow. Okay. All right, come on. Watch out for those jelly things.
And Mom found some poop.
Grandma did, I didn't bet.
Guess what? Grandma found poop.
We had no idea that we were coming out.
Good. Well, I think shinky pig's a great idea.
Yeah.
And then, I don't know, let me think about
a little bit of ideas,
but there's a good nap in there, and I also have
kids.
My computer,
please.
If you want to pull
here's
some
knock
stuff
it off.
Once I think I
put
can
it away.
And,
well, I wouldn't be able to get online here. I go through my cell phone, but if I don't have Sprint.
Oh, really?
Sprint.
Oh, that's a good idea. That's nice. Yeah.
Well, we got to even watch this paper.
Out on Brian's boat, it is Monday.
There's Washington, Brian.
July 10th, I believe. Okay, we're out on the island of Wash Craig, and we're in Brian's boat heading out to swim and to enjoy ourselves.
On the ocean!
On the Atlantic Ocean.
Let's go!
We even brought the dog. She's doing pretty good.
Hi!
Funny how that water's down.
There's a boat up here. If I can get it, where'd it go?
Okay, Bray, settle down. What is that?
A seashell.
Are you sure?
Grandma, look at this huge one.
Oh, wow.
What is that?
I see
it.
Those are oyster shells. That's an oyster shell. That's an oyster shell. Holy.
Awesome.
Brayden, go find your bag from Taylor, and then you can go wash off your seashell and put them right in. One chair or something, and when we need to sit, we'll just, I'll put it down on the sheet or something. What is it? What is it? Nikki would be loving this.
What's that?
Said Nikki would love this.
Oh, that's too bad. Nick wasn't here.
So I don't know if I have it on tape or not. So yeah, I should.
Guys! It's a live jellyfish! It's alive!
Wait, show me that cap now. Where is that? That full one.
What's it called?
Mom, look, a real jellyfish. Well, there's tentacles and everything. Brayden, where's the awesome crab?
I dropped it.
Why? Carrying it. It was like a crab or a shell. Okay, Jenna, give Bray some too. There's not much left.
Here's a kid.